Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's Tweak here, back again with another video. I've been asked a lot recently, what are your beginning wipe guns? What guns should I be using at the beginning of the wipe? Please, God, tell me some gun that I can use to kill people at the beginning of the wipe. And today, I'm going to have the answers for you guys. So, I got a couple of guns here that you guys can check out. Sorry, forgive the timer up here. We're doing a subathon right now, so we're going to be live for at least another 6 hours and 20 minutes. Who knows? It might go longer, might not. We'll see. But we're going to get into some gun builds now that you can use in the early game. You don't need any, like, insane attachments or builds or anything. All these guns I'm about to show you are all insanely effective. Can be easily found on your scav runs. Can be easily found off other scavs that you've killed. And easily found throughout your maps. So, let's get into it. So, lads, here we are. Probably the best early game gun, if not best gun to even get you to level 40. This gun can easily, like without a doubt, no problem get you to level 40. It can do all the PvE. You might struggle a little bit on scab bosses, but all you're going to do is you're going to get a PP19 and you're going to put a Cobra sight on it. That's it. This gun is a laser beam. It's so much easier to use than AKs in the early game. Yes, you're using 9mm instead of 5.45, but the PP19... is so cheap, so effective. The ammo's dirt cheap, the mags are dirt cheap. It's readily available everywhere you go. You will have peepees coming out your ears. And as I said, you can still use it to kill scab boss. Rashala's not too bad, provided they don't have visors. If they have visors, you can maybe try shooting him in the legs or just avoid them. But this gun right here, this is slept on by so many people, and I have no idea why. This gun, if you've never used it before in Tarkov, you want to just sell all your AKs and just use this in the early game. Very, very easy, very simple, very straightforward. So that is my first gun that I would suggest everybody to try. 10 out of 10. PP, 10 out of 10. Now, another gun that everybody sleeps on. I never see anybody using it. I used the last wipe at the end game to kill people during a viewer kit, and it did insane amounts of damage. Dropped people like no one's business. PPSH. Dirt cheap. You get LRMPC from Jaeger level 1, 35 round mags, crazy fire rate, little bit of recoil, aim for the chest, it'll bounce it up into their face, or shoot for their legs. This gun is like one of the best things about this gun. This is what I was saying about the TOS last patch and why it's such a good budget gun. You will always get this back in insurance. People will 9 out of 10 times leave this on the ground and it will just keep coming back and keep coming back and keep coming back. Now bear in mind, you need to make sure that the gun is, you know, repaired decently, I guess. If you do keep getting it back, just mind that because you don't want to be getting jams constantly. But yeah, the PPSH. Super high rate of fire. Anywhere in CQB, just point fire it, spray for the face area. One of the bullets will catch the face. And again, any visored enemies, you might want to aim for the legs. But yeah, as far as like killing scavs, killing players, killing scab bosses, it can all be done with this. Just maybe with a little bit of trickery, you know what I mean? So yeah, the other PP... maybe not quite as good as the PP19 because you can't put like a sight on it, so you're relying on the irons. But PPSH, very good. 9 out of 10 start of wipe weapon for sure. Now, here's the third gun. You guys will have seen this a lot before. The Vepr Hunter. As soon as you get Peacekeeper level 2, you get M80s. M80s go in here. Gun go bang. Shoot at head. Everything dies. Easy. Absolutely easy peasy. So all you got to do with this, again... you put a Cobra on it. You put a Cobra on it, or you can put one of these OKPs on it. You can put a PSO scope on it if you want to take it to woods or something. One of the most versatile, best early game guns that there is. The only thing that I really hate about this gun is the 5-round mags with the one in the chamber. Now, if you need to drop some chads, this gun is great. I hear this gun in raid, I run the other way, okay? Vepr Hunter, easily found on scavs. You can buy it from Jaeger level 2. Easy clap. But yeah, you'll find these all over the map usually. I've found tons of them on my scav runs. I found tons of them just on scavs around in the environments. Just make sure you put M80s in it. Don't use any of that shitty... the sports ammo or the BPZ FMJs or some shit. They're terrible. Don't use them. Put M80s in it, okay? Or if you find M61s in your raids, run it with M61s. And here we have the SKS, the mother of all early game guns. Now, I'm showing you specifically the OP SKS that has the dovetail on it, because I want to show you if you get one with the dovetail, you can put the PSO on it. And of course, you can also put you know, the EKP, you can put the OKP, and you can put whatever else you want on it. You put a night scope on it for all I give a shit. However, you can still run the gun with irons. The iron sights on the SKS are actually very easy to use. It's very nice. And the mags, these 20 rounders are available at level 1 Peacekeeper. Do not run the SKS with the 10 round internal magazine, because what will happen is you'll run out of bullets in the middle of a fight. You'll be reloading in the middle of a fight. You'll get pushed by a scav and you'll die. Spend the extra bit of money, get the 20 rounder, and you'll be absolutely laughing. So SKS, 20 rounder, iron sights, or if you have a dovetail, Cobra, OKP, PSO, 10 out of 10 Woods gun. 10 out of 10 gun for honestly most scenarios. The only place where this gun kind of fails is CQB, where you have to like smash left click if somebody gets right up in your face. But as far as like an early game like DMR substitute, absolutely fantastic. 10 out of 10 OPSKS. All right, next gun. If you want to spend a little bit more money, but you want to run a really bitchin' SMG, the MP5. You want to get your hands on one of these MFI mounts, put that on there, slap whatever optic you want on there, and then just run it as is. You can suppress it if you want. If you found the attachments and the adapters and stuff, you can do that if you want. But honestly, just run it loud and proud. Just put the MFI mount on it. Put some PSTs in it. Off you go. The MP5 is an absolute beast of a gun. Always has been. Probably always will be. And it's just one of those guns that's super fun to run. Run it now in the early game, because once we get to the mid game and the end game, the MP5 kind of, you know, loses its effectiveness unless you're running it with 7N. But this gun with PSTs, absolutely no issues dropping anybody. Again, if you run into visors and stuff, you know the deal. Aim for the legs. So yeah, MP5, a little bit more on the expensive side, but if you got that extra money lying around, you want to have some fun, run the MP5. And if you can buy the MFI mounts, because they're constantly sold out of Peacekeeper, it's very annoying. But MP5, early game gun, 7 out of 10, just because it's a little bit more on the expensive side. And here we have it, the gun that everybody just vendors or sells to fence or takes the flashlight off and leaves it behind. Lads, the 153 is a really, really, really good gun. If you guys can find a 153 that has 8 shells in the mag capacity department, not the 4-shell, it is a god gun. For factory, for customs, you can run slugs in it. You can run leg meta ammo. You can absolutely demolish people with this. As soon as you get access to flechettes, chest shots at close range with the 153, you will absolutely own everybody. And it's also a phenomenal insurance gun. You will constantly get 153s back in insurance. If you can afford it, you can stick the old sperm mount on there and you can put an optic on it. It is absolutely up to you. Most of them will always already have a sprut with some kind of light on it or something like that. If you want to get really fancy with it, you know, you can put the pistol grip on there. You know, you can suppress it. You can do all kinds of crap with it. But honestly, just running it dead stock, you know, not even an optic on it, this gun is still absolutely fantastic. And nobody ever picks them up because, one, they won't fit in their bags. And if they have another gun that they might want to run instead in their backup gun slot, they're not going to pick up yours. Especially in the early game, it will be left behind. If you do put a suppressor on it, your suppressor will get stolen. Your optic will probably get stolen. But the gun, 9 out of 10 times, will always come back. So yeah, 153. Fantastic gun. Very, very good. Just make sure you find the 8-rounders in it. You can kill scab boss with this. You can kill players with this. You can absolutely decimate people. Just get the highest damage flesh rounds you have, aim for the legs, or if you have any type of armor penetrating rounds, aim for the chest or the head, and you will absolutely slap people off the map with it. So there you have it, lads. Those are my picks for some of the best early game guns that nobody ever really uses that much, to be honest with you. A couple of honorable mentions. RFB is pretty good. The 136 Vepr is pretty good. If you want an AK style, you know, 7.62x39. Obviously, of course, you know, the Keter, but I can't list all the guns. So guys, make sure you check out all these weapons. If you haven't used some of them before, I definitely recommend you give them a try. Might be game changing for you. And have fun absolutely slapping on PMCs, getting your quests done, and good luck on getting to level 40. So guys, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure to leave a like, leave a comment down below. Let me know what guns are your favorites in the early game. And if you want to come watch live, this video is going to be going up at some point while I'm live, so you can just go click on the link down below and come watch us play live. I am currently, let me double check for you, we are level 27, halfway to level 28, going for level 30, maybe level 31 tonight. So guys, I'll see you guys in the next video, or I'll see you on the stream. Peace out, my dudes.